From June 2024, qualified workers from third world countries will be able to enter Germany for work purposes under certain rules, which these immigration rules have been greatly lowered as compared to the regular tight scrutiny when applying for a visa. Now, the new work in Germany rules starting this June gives anyone going to Germany more opportunities to obtain professional recognition by taking part in a qualification measure. And once you pass through the qualification measure, it becomes possible to get your spouse to Germany if you so wish when you receive your residence permit for the first time on or after June 2024. Now, interestingly, this new immigration act will make it easier for skilled workers with vocational training and people with practical knowledge of their profession to immigrate to Germany. Now, if you're wondering why Germany is lowering work visa requirements, especially for IT specialists, it is because Germany is facing severe skill shortage, meaning that companies are struggling to fill open positions due to high demand for skilled workers. Now, pay attention, because what you need to know is that Germany has the work visa as well as the job seeker visa. Now, the job seeker visas are for those looking to move to Germany for work or those already in the country looking for work. Now, job seeker visas are valid for 6 months and you can work for up to 10 hours a week. The exciting news is that as of June 2024, this month, there will also be the opportunity card, which can be issued for up to 1 year, meaning it will allow for part-time work. Now, in order for you to understand the benefit of the opportunity card, you need to know what the German work visa entails. Now, the German work visa is for people who already have job offers in Germany and allows them to live and work, meaning you must have already received a job offer from a company before you go about applying for a visa, and your employer must assist by providing proof of the offer as well as various company details. Now, the German work visa takes about 2 to 4 weeks to process and is valid for 3 to 6 months. Now, you can then apply for a residence permit, which is valid for up to 4 years or in line with your employment contract. One thing you need to understand is that the German work visa application requirements include proof of accommodation, financial means, and a signed contract from an employer, which most people may qualify to access. But the requirements for a foreign degree recognized as being equivalent to a German bachelor's degree is where most people will fall short. That is why, starting from June 2024, this month, the German opportunity card is something that you must look into, because it doesn't prioritize the requirement for a bachelor's degree. As long as you have a skill to offer the country, you have the green light, you are good to go. Now, there are currently over 1 million job vacancies in Germany waiting to be filled. So if you are interested, this is probably one of the easiest time to make an application for the move to Germany. So requirements to access the German opportunity card is calculated by points with 2 years experience in whichever field that you are in, whether you are an electrician, you're a carpenter, a paralegal, nurse, pharmacy, technician, dressmaking, construction, graphic designer, cleaning, plumber, web designer. As long as you have 2 years experience, you can go to the website, which I will drop in the link below, to calculate the opportunity now. We are already in the month of June, so when you go on the site, you will see working in Germany with the opportunity card. You will notice the subheading, use your professional training to immigrate to Germany. You can enter start to begin. You will follow the prompts to apply by selecting your nationality. So let's just say Ghana. Now, if you live in a different country other than the country you selected, you choose yes. But if you live in the same country of your nationality, you select no. Then you will be asked if you have any qualifications, perhaps any vocational training with professional qualification or a university degree. If you don't, it is fine. You can choose no, I do not have any formal professional qualifications, and proceed. You then choose if you can speak the German language, in this case, not at all. How well do you speak English? If you are fluent, you have the option. If you can communicate effectively on a business level, choose the first option and proceed. Then you can select your age range and then confirm if you possess work experience which is suitable or which suits your professional qualification or university degree if you have one. Then you'll be asked the option to select if you can provide evidence of 2 years or less of professional experience in the field. After, you will be prompted to choose if your formal qualification is a bottleneck profession, meaning if your qualification or skill is considered to be in short supply. Because remember, Germany has shortage in certain specific areas that they will prioritize in their selection for this opportunity. So you will see a list to choose from in healthcare, educational sector like a teacher, IT, and so much more. But if you are not in these areas, you can say no and proceed. But most people also fall into the IT sector, so you will select IT, information technology. Now, if you have resided in Germany legally for a continuous period of at least 6 months in the last 5 years, you will be required to select, in this case, I will assume no, so we will select the option. Remember that if you are married and you wish to travel to Germany with your partner, it is possible and Germany provides for that option. So if you are married, you will be required to select yes, I would like to move to Germany with my partner. But if not, you can simply say no, I will be moving to Germany alone. Now, do you have sufficient financial resources to secure your livelihood, at least 12,000 euros or 12,300 euros per person? Well, this is where it becomes challenging for most, but you have to be honest. If you have the finances, say yes. If you don't, just say, I do not possess the required amount. Because if you claim you have the money and you are required to provide proof later on with a bank statement and you don't and provide a fake bank statement, the embassies these days make the efforts to do an investigation and find out if the financial document you provided is truly valid or false. So it's better to be honest than risk losing the opportunity by providing false documents. Do you already have a job offer from an employer? If not, select no and click finish. You will be required to provide your first name and your email address to agree to the processing of the data you provided, and that's it for the application. Now, a lot of people who are applying with their qualifications need to convert their certificates into German standard, and the site that you can use is Annaben. Now, the website checks if your qualification is recognized in Germany, and there are many tutorials online to learn from step-by-step approach, but I will leave the link in the description below, because once you do this, you will have the certificate of recognition that your qualification is recognized in Germany, and you can now proceed. Now, a very important factor to note is that when you do not have the 12,000 euros asked when filling the opportunity card, a way to get around that is by having a job offer from an employer in Germany when filling the form. When you have a job offer, you do not need the proof of funds. That is why I will add a link in the description on the website to find job offers before you start the process. Now, you can check out English Jobs website, which has a broad job market and offers in a very expanded area of endeavor or fields, if I can boldly say, to choose from and apply for a job. Now, I hope this information was useful to you. If it was, kindly drop a like on this video. And if you have any questions, drop it below and I'll answer you. My name is Shore Heritage, a traveler and explorer currently exploring Ghana. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.